The souls of the saints are rejoicing in heaven, the saints who follow the footsteps of Christ, and since for love of him they shed their blood, they are absorbed with Christ forever. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Sisters and brothers, today we commemorate the first holy martyrs of the Holy Roman Church. So let us ask these holy men and women to pray for us and pray with us in this holy mass, and to prepare ourselves to be worthy to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Let us call to mind our sins, asking the Lord for forgiveness and mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are mighty God and Prince of Peace. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are Son of God and Son of Mary. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are Word made flesh and splendor of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who consecrated the abundant first fruits of the Roman Church by the blood of the martyrs, grant me, pray, that with firm courage we may together draw strength from so great a struggle and ever rejoice at the triumph of faithful love. To our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, if God is for us, who can be against us? He did not spare his own Son, but handed him over for us all. How will he not also give us everything else along with him? Who will bring a charge against God's chosen ones? It is God who acquits us. Who will condemn? It is Christ Jesus who died, rather was raised, who also is at the right hand of God, who indeed intercedes for us. What will separate us from the love of Christ? Will anguish, or distress, or persecution, or famine, or nakedness, or peril, or the sword? As it is written, for your sake we are being slain all the day. We are looked upon as sheep to be slaughtered. No, in all these things we conquer overwhelmingly through him who loved us. For I am convinced that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor present things, nor future things, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our soul has been rescued like a bird from the fowler's snare.
Our soul has been rescued like a bird from the fowler's snare.
Had not the Lord been with us, when men rose up against us, then would they have swallowed us alive, when their fury was inflamed against us. Our soul has been rescued like a bird from the fowler's snare. Then would the waters have overwhelmed us, the torrent would have swept over us. Over us then would have swept the raging waters.
Our soul has been rescued like a bird from the fowler's snare.
Broken was the snare, and we were free. Our help is in the name of the Lord, who made heaven and earth.
Our soul has been rescued like a bird from the fowler's snare.
Of the heart and on the lips of the people, pray this gospel worthy and well in the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Blessed are they who are persecuted for the sake of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to his disciples, "See that no one deceives you. For many will come in my name, saying, 'I am the Christ,' and they will deceive many. You will hear of wars and reports of wars. See that you are not alarmed, for these things must happen, but it will not yet be the end. Nation will rise against nation, and kingdom against kingdom. There will be famines and earthquakes from place to place. All these are the beginning of the labor pains. Then they will hand you over to persecution and they will kill you. You will be hated by all nations because of my name. And then many will be led into sin. They will betray and hate one another. Many false prophets will arise and deceive many. And because of the increase of evil doing, the love of many will grow cold. But the one who perseveres to the end will be saved." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
On the day after the feast of Saint Peter and Saint Paul, the great apostles who laid the foundation of our church, we commemorate the first holy martyrs of the Roman Church. These were the first Christians being persecuted en masse by the Roman Emperor Nero in the year 64. So in those days, becoming Christian meant accepting death. These Christians were put to death by being crucified, being fed to wild animals, or being tied and laid up as human torches. Sisters and brothers, as the Lord Jesus, who was opposed by many, beaten and crucified, so did his first disciples. As Jesus foretold in today's gospel, they will hand you over to persecution and they will kill you. You will be hated by all nations because of my name. The first holy martyr of the Holy Roman Church gave their lives to Christ, and their blood was truly the seed of the church, because 2,000 years later, after their death, the church has grown from a small group of people to a church with over 1.2 million Christians. Human force and persecution could not stop the growth of the church. It only makes faith grow stronger. Because if God is with us, who can be against us? Let us pray. Trusting in the God who is always for us, we humbly turn to him with our prayers and petitions. For the Holy Mother Church, may God inspire our leaders as true ministers of hearing. We pray to our Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For those who lead nations and people, may the Holy Spirit give them fortitude and courage
to serve their people, we pray to O Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For those suffering in the storms of life, may the Lord bring them comfort to his body, the church. We pray to O Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For Saint Anne family, may God bless us and keep us free from all harm during the pandemic and the hurricane season. We pray to O Lord. For the faithful departed, particularly those who have no one to pray for them, may they live forever in the joy of the heavenly kingdom. We pray to O Lord. Eternal Father, we praise you for your kindness and ask you to hear the prayers of your family, which we ask to Christ our Lord.
For to your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for to your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Wash me, O Lord, for my iniquity and cleanse me for my sin. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept your sacrifice and your hand. The grace of the Lord is made, for our good and
the Lord
of all the
church. Receive, Holy Father, the offerings we bring in commemoration of the holy martyrs, and grant that we, your servants, may be found steadfast in confessing your name, to Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
And in the love of the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you are glorified when your saints are praised. Their very sufferings are but wonders of your might. In your mercy, you give honor to their faith, to their endurance. You grant firm resolve, and in their struggle, the victory is yours through Christ our Lord. Therefore, O creatures of heaven and earth, sing a new song in adoration, and we, with all the hosts of angels, cry out, and without end, we acclaim,
Holy, 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 holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the power of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, this gift we pray by sending down the Spirit upon them that you move for, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith, save us, Savior,
for by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered to one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Gregory, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us, all we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and the first holy martyrs of the Roman Church, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. To him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, O glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God,
take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I know what did I use to do, and I know the only Savior who are less
than It is you who have stood by me in my trials, and I confer a kingdom on you, says the Lord, that you may eat and drink at my table in my kingdom. Those who join us, lastly, let us pray the spiritual communion prayer. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who in your holy martyrs have wonderfully made known the mystery of the cross, graciously grant that joy and strength from this sacrifice we may cling faithfully to Christ and labor in the church for the salvation of all. To Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
To kneel at your altar, in faith we draw near. Let our Lord by Mary, your daughter so dear. O good saint, we call on your name, your praises loud, your children proclaim. O good come, Holy Spirit, fill the hearts of your faithful, and kindle in them the fire of your love. Send forth your Spirit, and they shall be created, and you shall renew the face of the earth. Let us pray. Father, impart the hearts of your faithful people by sending them the light of the Holy Spirit. In that Spirit, give us thy judgment and the joy of his comfort and guidance. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Chaplet of St. Anne, the first mystery. Meditate on St. Anne's role as wife of St. Joachim and mother of the Blessed Virgin Mary. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
As we forget those that pass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now, the hour of death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and
at the hour of death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of death.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, now and forever. Amen.
Saint Anne, Mother of the Blessed Virgin Mary.
Pray for us.
The second mystery. Meditate on Mary's cooperation with God's plan for the salvation of mankind. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for sinners now and at the
hour of death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for sinners now and at the hour of death.
Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for sinners now and at the hour of death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for sinners now and at the hour of death.
Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for sinners now and at the hour of death.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, now and
Son and Mother of the Blessed Virgin Mary.
Pray for us.
The third mystery, meditate on God becoming man, Jesus Christ, our Redeemer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of death.
Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God,
pray for sinners now and at the hour of death. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for sinners now and at the hour of death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for
sinners now. Saint Anne, Mother of the Blessed Virgin Mary. Good Saint Anne, you were privileged to be the Mother of Mary, God's Mother and ours, and so you overflow your grace among the saints. We turn to you with confidence because of your closeness to Mary, and also because you have always shown your power and willingness to have those devoted to you. To this loveliness again, I ask you to help me each day to come closer to Jesus to Mary. Give me a heart for sin, which separates me from God, and teach me to love my neighbor as myself. I place before you the special intentions of this novena. Please recommend them to Mary, that she may bring them before her Son Jesus. Intercede for me, Saint Anne, that I may follow Jesus more closely in the vocation in life to which he has called me, so that when this life is over, I may with Mary and you and all the saints enjoy the vision of God face to face. Amen. Ever Immaculate Virgin, Mother of Mercy, help of the sick, refuge of sinners, comfort of the afflicted. You know my wants, my troubles, my suffering. Aim to cast upon me the look of mercy by appearing in the water of the Lord. You will please to make a great sanctuary where you dispense your favors, and the way many sufferers have obtained the cure of their infirmities, both spiritual and corporal. I come therefore with the most unbounded confidence to implore your maternal intercession. Obtain, O loving Mother, the
granted of my requests.
True gratitude for your favors. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Through the intercession of Saint Anne, may the Lord bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
In time of temptation,